Yeah. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button.
Also, don't forget to like the video and enjoy.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy iPod King Carter here, and today we're going to be doing a review of the SCUF Gaming Vantage. The Vantage provides a Xbox layout and feel to a controller for a PlayStation, and it comes with not only the two paddles that came with the Infinity 4 PS, but it comes with a total of four paddles and two side buttons that are called SAX buttons. I don't know why they call them that, but they're called SAX buttons. Those are the buttons that are directly on the sides of the controller. And it also comes with a dope audio touch bar for the bottom of the controller for most people that plug into their headsets. Just like me, I use Astros, so I will plug a pair of A40s or A10s into the bottom of the controller, and I would be able to control the audio from party or game or whatever the case may be with just a touch on the touch bar. Now, also, the big thing about this controller is that you can play with it Bluetooth or you can play with it wired, and it comes in two different styles, and it's pretty pricey. A lot of people have been hitting me up ever since the controller came out saying, how do I feel about it? How do I like it? And I know this is why you're here. And I'm here to tell you that when the first controller dropped and I got it in my hands, I couldn't stand it. I did not like it. It was not to my liking at all. I went to the mock court, tried out a couple dribble moves, tried out with a couple shots, and I felt like there was something missing. And literally, weeks later, I was on Reddit and I seen so many people having some of the same problems that I was having. And that was dead zones on the joysticks, not being able to connect to your PlayStation 4 wired, or not being able to set up the Bluetooth on your PS4, or you just wouldn't be able to turn this sucker on. When this controller was not showing me no love, I shelved it. I can tell you guys right now, full on, I shelved the SCUF Vantage and I went back to my Infinity 4 PS because I felt like it was the right controller for my situation. If I wanted to take the paddles off, no biggie, I'll just unscrew them. Or I'll keep the paddles on, and I used to double tap the right side for alley-oops, and I used to double tap this side for flashy passes. So most people that get the SCUF Vantage that play 2K, most people took off the SAX buttons, most people took off the paddles, and they just played with it like an Xbox controller for PS4. So let's go ahead and update the SCUF Vantage right now. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to my PC, and we'll actually turn on NBA 2K, go to the mock court, and check the dead zone and see if the dead zone issue still exists, or see if they have been fixed, or just see if it's still rocky. Let's hop into it.
All right, to all my SCUF Vantage owners out there, the first thing you're going to want to do is go to the SCUF Gaming website and download the update. I'll leave the link inside the description. Now, as things come out of boxes such as iPhones, PS4s, everything nowadays, man, all technology always needs updates. And I guess even for controllers, that is still the same fact. So what you want to do is open up the software and start calibrating. Now, what I'm going to do is show you guys my actual hands and controller. I know this is pretty weird. It's always so awkward, but it's just me spinning the sticks, doing what the calibration wants me to do. Now, all calibration was with the sticks. I didn't have to calibrate the paddles. I didn't have to calibrate any other button inputs or anything like that. And you want to make sure before you update your SCUF, you want to read everything on screen. You don't want to just rush into it and try to calibrate your PS4 controller. You want to make sure that you always read the directions. Because if you don't read the directions and you somehow break your controller, or your controller doesn't properly update, then that's on you. But if it still doesn't update and you did everything to the T, you definitely want to hit up SCUF Gaming via email, on Twitter, whatever the case may be. Get in touch with them and get your controller fixed. Let's go ahead and hop into the review on NBA 2K.
Now that we are back to my court, I wanted to actually test the dead zones for you guys because I did just get the update. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move my player after I shoot the green. Hold up. First of all, that's my first shot. You guys seen it here first. I ain't gonna say it's the SCUF, you know what I'm saying, but I'm a slasher. So check this out. I'm gonna just check the dead zone real quick just to show you guys what it's all about. Now, if you guys aren't familiar with what dead zones actually are, it's basically that point between when your controller actually gets a button press and when your player actually moves. So let's go ahead and give it a little nod. Oh, hold up. Okay, let me see. Okay, a little, just a little nudge. Just checking to see if my player responds to the little flicking of the stick. Okay, if you guys see here, You see my mind player starting to take steps. As soon as I touch it and give it a little bit of life. Now, a lot of people, I'm not sure if it's dead zones with other people's scuff right now, but what I'm gonna do is okay, and my player is literally walking at this point. All right, so let me see what it looks like with a full run. Okay. Now, I'm not sure, but I feel like the responsiveness is still a little bit slow, but that might just be me, or it may be my court. Let me just run from foul line to foul line. What do you guys think? This is literally a question for every 2K head out here. Now, I know that if I had like a playmaking sharpshooter or a pure playmaker or something like that, and as I was spamming my dribble moves, you guys probably could see. But speaking of dribble moves, I don't have many, but let's just check some out. All right, little double tap. All right. What do you guys think so far? Let me little hezzy. All right, one time for the okay. Let's glitch out real quick. All right, so we can still glitch up and all that. All right, you know what I'm saying? All right, my spins and stuff is still there. Green, hold up, man. Scuff, what are you doing to my player? He doesn't green like this. What are you doing? You gonna make me go to the mob parking and set it off? Y'all better stop playing with me. Let me give you guys a little bit of background about me and Scuff Gaming's relationship. A few years ago, I hit up Scuff Gaming wanting to review one of their controllers. And since I was a sports gamer, coming over to their space where they dominated first-person shooters controller-wise, they wanted to really get my view on how to work the controller with sports gaming, such as Madden, NBA 2K, NBA Live, FIFA, things of that nature. Now, as the years went on, they sent me products to, you know, show off or, you know, check out new designs and things of that nature. I never really got my own controller, but in recent years, they sparked a deal with what everybody knows is the NBA 2K League. If you guys aren't privy to the NBA 2K League, it's all about pro-am, it's all about comp. So a lot of players that play comp, that play Call of Duty, Overwatch, Fortnite, all these crazy first-person shooter games are used to the Scuff brand. But when it came to 2K, nobody really knew how they would work in the gaming space. And I'm here to tell you guys firsthand. I went to a 2K event and I noticed that players did play with the Scuff controllers, but they played without the paddles. They felt like the connection was pretty good, but they played with it like it was a base standard PlayStation controller. All right, guys, so this is probably the part of the video where a lot of people are gonna be in the comments, you know, telling me that I got an egghead and, you know, telling me that my opinion doesn't matter, telling me to just, you know, go under a rock and die. Oh, you know, all the horrible comments, but I'm gonna be looking for those comments of a little bit of positivity, you know, to those who like to see these type of review videos that I will be bringing back to my channel. Now, as far as the Scuff Vantage goes, I will have to give it my seal of disapproval for NBA 2K. And the reason why I give it a disapproval is because as YouTubers or content creators, as they would call us, for this game, I don't think the Scuff Vantage is good for competitive play, because I don't want anyone ever saying that the reason that they lost the game, whether it came down to a last shot, a crossover, anything like that, is because of the Scuff Vantage and the amount of buttons that it has. Now, as far as first-person shooters, as far as third-person shooters such as Fortnite, I believe the Scuff Vantage is perfect for those games. As far as me using the Scuff Vantage, I got a few greens. I'm not opposed to getting greens, but what I would probably do is take off all of the buttons with my Shot Slasher and take off every single paddle, all the sax buttons and play with the Vantage for about a week and give you guys, I guess, an extra updated review about if the controller's for me on 2K. Now, as far as you, if you would like to get this controller, it is totally up to you. I'm not telling anybody right now to drop $200 plus on a controller if your controller stick game is fine in its own right. But if you want to be able to have that security, I would actually recommend another SCUF product to you, which is the Infinity 4PS. And the reason why I would tell you guys that is because that one only comes with two paddles. It's built like a PS4 controller, like a standard PS4 controller, and you don't have to worry about the risk of running into any other connectivity issues that the SCUF Vantage had in previous time when it first came out. Now, for all my SCUF Vantage owners that literally shelved it like I did, if you shelved your Vantage, it is time to update it. Like I said, for any SCUF Vantage owners out there right now, if you have been going through the same motions as I have with the dead zone problems, connectivity issues, please update your SCUF Vantage. For all other users out there, consumers out there that want to get a SCUF product, I would try out the Infinity 4PS if you like the build of a regular PS4 controller. If you are coming from Xbox and you're transitioning and saying, I used to be Xbox, but it ain't that much comp there. I want to come to PS4, but I can't stand their controllers. The SCUF Vantage might be for you. But I would say, as a 2K head, a sports gamer, you might not need all them paddles and stuff like that, my G. Unless you are a playmaker of some sort. If you like throwing alley-oops, if you like throwing flashy passes, which I really don't see too much unless people are playing with me and my slasher or other pure slashers. I see people throwing lobs and stuff like that. But for a pure sharp, what a pure sharp going to do with paddles besides make all of them the shoot button? Just saying. But hey, man, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Now remember, this review was from a NBA 2K, NBA Live, Madden 19, like sports gamer. I'm a complete sports gamer. I dabble in a little bit of first person shooters and third person shooters, but I am not elite comp over there, okay? See what I'm saying? I am a sports gamer. So if you're a sports gamer and you gotta feel how I feel, then you got my review, man. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure you guys drop a like if you want to see more videos like this. If you like the way it was edited, hey, I'm nice. Peace, y'all.
Yeah. You can't watch this whole video without subscribing.